Welcome back. Strawberries and rhubarb are summer's best friends, right? And we're cooking them up together in this quintessential crisp this morning with Bob Sferra, chef and owner of Culinary Occasions. He is one busy bee.
We are very busy.
My goodness, you got a lot going on.
We do. Summer's the best, but summer, you know, we're outside. We're catering all over the city of Cleveland. We're also at the Cleveland Flea, so that's something new for us.
So what are you guys doing out there?
So at the Cleveland Flea, we're doing, we're kind of really focusing on our pastry, so we're doing gift boxes. We've got really cool homemade s'mores kits where we're making the graham crackers, making the marshmallows, making the chocolate bars, and then we do all kinds of other little like Subway cookies and we got crisp on the screen, and we've got our s'mores kits up front. But this is the box right here? Yes, exactly.
So it comes with the full kit. I mean, you don't have to buy...
You need a fire and a stick. That's all you need in that box. Yeah, we make it all from scratch.
That's so cool.
Yeah.
Look how fun that is.
Yeah, we love to celebrate summer, and we celebrate local food. I literally went to the farmer's market on Saturday, got local strawberries, rhubarb, which is a very weird vegetable. A lot of times people are sort of afraid of rhubarb. Just a little bit of sugar is all rhubarb really takes. But I think the key in this one is instead of trying to make a pie, which is cumbersome and a lot of steps, make a crisp. So in making a crisp, we basically just combine the fruit with a little bit of cornstarch.
Okay.
The cornstarch, you just kind of let it sit for a little bit, and the cornstarch will help to like leach out some of the liquid. And I put a little orange zest in there also.
Okay.
But the nice thing about, I'm gonna add a little bit of orange juice to that also, and I'm gonna add a little bit of sugar just to kind of tame down the acidity factor of the rhubarb.
So when you look to buy the rhubarb?
Yeah, you want to look for, I actually like to look for really red stalks.
Okay.
It looks like celery.
It has
nothing to do with celery. It grows with these giant, really beautiful big leaves that are actually poisonous if you eat a lot of them.
Oh my.
But the rhubarb itself, you want the stalk part.
Okay.
So simple, very simple again. We just had rhubarb, sugar, cornstarch, a little bit of orange juice, a little bit of orange zest, and then we're just gonna take that and put that in a casserole. So again, you don't have to worry about doing a pie crust or putting anything in there first. That's probably a little bit much for that. But
this is so good, especially for a Saturday.
This is
delicious.
Can't
you do this for breakfast too?
Why not? Yeah, it's practically granola, right?
It's just
as healthy. And then, of course, we make a crisp to go on top.
Okay.
So when you make the crisp part to go on top, it's basically flour and brown sugar. There's a little bit of salt in there as well. We'll put a little bit of white sugar in there as well. And all of this gets mixed up together. I'll have to get my hands in here a little bit. We mix this up together, and then it does require a good amount of butter.
So the butter, of course.
You could do this with a mixer, you could do it with your hand, but the butter you're gonna crumble all in there, and what's gonna happen is you're gonna have almost like tiny little pea-sized shapes of the butter flour mixture all mixed together. When we're done, we're gonna add oats to that as well. And again, we just kind of keep mixing it. You can use your hands, you can use a standing mixer, but the idea is to just kind of pull all of it together without really creaming it.
It seems so easy.
It's super simple. And the end result is this right here. So you've got this wonderful crisp. Exactly.
It's just
all those things mixed together. And then, again, getting away from our pie is that this is it. This is our topping. It makes it super simple. Once this hits the oven, what happens is you'll see all of the liquid coming out of the fruit, and it sort of bubbles up to the top.
Yeah.
It's absolutely delicious.
How long do you cook it for?
This is probably about a half an hour cook in a 350-degree oven.
Boy, that's not bad at all.
Yeah, it's really simple. And this is a keeper, too. So make it today, you know, serve it for a couple days, or serve it hot right out of the oven. We even make them individually for parties, so you could have one for each guest at the table for a catered event.
Now, for those of you who maybe have never hired Bob Sferra, you're missing out. He's got a whole catalog here.
We do.
So what are you guys doing this summer? How can people... You do weddings, too,
and
parties.
We do everything. Yeah. Weddings, bar mitzvahs, graduations. Yeah. Go to our website, culinaryoccasions.com. Come and see us at the Flea on July 14th. Down at Tyler Village.
Okay.
And have something to eat. Oh, hi. They always come to visit when there's a snack involved.
They do. I have to call in my friends. That's what they call it.
And sometimes you don't even have to call us in.
No, we'll just
I don't
just
think like I heard you call
I'm
us.
I'm pretty sure I didn't summon you guys. That's cool.
Of course, we have whipped cream there. Oh, my goodness. Only two plates. I think you guys are going to have to share.
I am willing to give up my plate for you.
Or you know what? You could have this, Christy. I could just
go. No,
really. Okay, so all of the information is on our screen. We'll put on our website, fox8.com. Bob, thank you. You always do such a great job. He has all these little things.
Goodies.
It's still warm.
It's so fun.
Is it still warm?
Oh, yeah.
So it should be served.
Oh, perfect. Yeah. That's awesome. Mm.